Today we are going to discuss about difference between fire tube boiler and water tube boiler. It's a very important question for the exam point of view. Welcome to my YouTube channel Mechanical Engineering Management. Like, share and subscribe. So we are going to write over here the difference between fire tube boiler and water tube boiler. So very simple that you have to remember, in case of fire tube, the fire, that means flue gases are passing through the tube. In case of water tube, water is passing through the tube. That you have to remember in your mind. So automatically you can understand so many difference between fire tube boiler and water tube boiler. First, hot gases inside the tubes, that means you can say the flue gases inside the tube, and so that water is outside the tube. In case of water tube boiler, water inside the tube and hot gases outside the tube. Generally, fire tube boiler are internally fired, whereas water tube boiler are generally externally fired. And you know that internally fired, that means the furnace that is inside the boiler shell. Externally fired, that means the furnace that is outside the boiler shell. Third, operating pressure is limited to 25 bar in case of fire tube boiler. In case of water tube boiler, operating pressure is high up to 125 bar. In case of fire tube boiler, rate of steam generation is low because of the pressure is up to the 25 bar only. So the steam generation rate is low. And so that you can understand, in case of water tube boiler, rate of steam generation is high because of you can increase the pressure up to 125 bar. In case of fire tube boiler, not suitable for large power plant because of steam generation is low. Here steam generation is high, and so that it is suitable for the large power plant. Initial cost is low because of it is up to the 25 bar pressure. Initial cost is high because of it is suitable for large power plant. Operating cost is high. Obviously, you can understand, whereas initial cost is low, so second side is always operating cost is high. Here initial cost is high, so obviously you can understand operating cost is low. In case of fire tube boiler, less skill required for the efficient operation. So particularly for the fire tube boiler, skill is not so much important. Whereas in case of water tube boiler, more skill is actually required or the efficient operation of the water tube boiler. In case of fire tube boiler, water treatment is not required because flue gases are passing through the tubes. So that outside of the tube water is there, and so that water treatment is not required. Whereas in case of water tube boiler, water treatment is required. To prevent the scaling problem inside the tubes, water treatment is required. Overall efficiency is around 70% in case of fire tube boiler, whereas in case of water tube boiler, the efficiency is up to 90%, and that's why it is generally suitable for the large power plant. Less chance of explosion because of the pressure is up to 25 bar. Here more chances of explosion because of the pressure is up to 125 bar. All parts are not easily accessible for cleaning, inspection and repair. Whereas in case of water tube boiler, all parts are easily accessible for cleaning, inspection and repair. And that we have seen in case of the Babcock-Wilcox boiler. Shell diameter is larger per unit power. Whereas in case of water tube boiler, shell diameter is smaller per unit power. So if you compare per unit power, then shell diameter is larger in case of fire tube boiler. Use for process steam in sugar, paper and chemical industries. Use for process steam as well as power generation. So thanks my dear friends, press the like button to appreciate this video.